This is Emily, the emergency integrated life-saving lanyard. It's a jet-powered water rescue robot used by lifeguards around the world.
The couple of things they use Emily for is that you throw it in the water and you can run out to a person with a line, all right? So you can pull them off the rocks. You can also, you know, run that boat out to them and they can hang on.
With support from the National Science Foundation, computer scientist Robin Murphy and a team from Texas A&M University are creating new software tools designed to make this robot and others a whole lot smarter.
We typically don't build the robots, we add to them.
To do it, she picks the brains of the best lifeguards in the business, like the Baywatch team from Los Angeles County in California. Today, they are in Marina del Rey, but they safeguard more than 70 miles of coastline, and they're always on the lookout for better tools, like a smarter Emily, that can help them do their jobs better.
What I think we'll do is we'll make us more efficient. What I mean with that is they'll reduce the time for certain tasks that we do that, you know, right now take a long time.
On this day, Murphy and her team are getting feedback from the lifeguards on some new Emily upgrades designed to help it steer itself more autonomously.
When you try to game it yourself, you often go too fast, too slow, this and this. And that's wasting both energy and time to getting out to that person. So you want the computers to get better, the algorithms to start learning the patterns.
They're testing out a new user interface, navigating using thermal sensors to locate people in the water, and fine-tuning a system that automatically slows the robot down as it approaches its target.
You want that robot boat not to just blindly zoom over there and run the victim down, but now use artificial intelligence to slow down.
They're customizing these new programs for large-scale water rescues. Imagine a capsized ferry or water taxi. Murphy's team developed their upgrade plans during field research in the Mediterranean, where the Greek Coast Guard used Emily to rescue hundreds of refugees from the water. She says without advances in robot intelligence, tools like Emily won't scale up to handle large disasters.
So now, if we can give them an Emily that they point and they bear, you know, or just get it started over there, or enter in the go that direction, and it can go over there, and they don't have to worry. They know that those group of people look like they're okay. If they can just hang on for a while, we'll get to them. Let me jump in the water and deal with that guy.
They're also working with tethered drones. Murphy says the new Smart Emily can navigate even better by accessing an eye in the sky.
If it just had some sort of feedback, it could slow down and go straighter, better, faster. Well, if you've got a camera in the air, whoa, now you can start looking at Emily, because she's bright orange, and you can start slowing her down, making her go faster, making her optimal.
Saving lives with smarter robots. For Science Nation, I'm Miles O'Brien.